Two other important terms specified in the first module of the syllabus are constant voltage source and constant current source. So let's go through constant voltage source first. So what is a voltage source? Voltage source can be termed as an energy source that establishes a potential difference or a voltage. Potential difference or a voltage across its terminals. Simply, a voltage source is one which gives a voltage across its terminals. It is a source of energy which gives a voltage or potential difference across its terminals. Example, battery. Battery is an example of a voltage source. So next one is constant voltage source. Constant voltage source can be also termed as constant voltage source is also termed as ideal voltage source. So it is an ideal concept, constant or ideal concept. It can be defined as a constant voltage source is one that maintains a constant terminal voltage no matter how much current is drawn from it. So this is the definition for a constant voltage source. A constant voltage source is a source that maintains a constant terminal voltage no matter how much current is drawn from it. That is, constant voltage source always provides us a constant voltage, and the current drawn from the source is independent of the voltage across its terminals. That is, the current drawn does not depend on the terminal voltage, or it can be represented as the terminal voltage is independent of current drawn. So a constant voltage source is one which maintains a constant terminal voltage across its terminals no matter how much current is drawn from it. That is, the terminal voltage of a constant voltage source is independent of the current drawn. A constant voltage source is considered to be zero internal resistance. Constant voltage source has zero internal resistance. That is, when the current drawn from the source varies from zero value to infinity, the terminal voltage will remain always unaffected. That is, even though the current varies from a minimum value to maximum value, the voltage will always remain constant. That is an explanation for a constant voltage source, because it has zero internal resistance. A constant voltage source can be represented by, this is an expression used to represent a constant voltage source, positive, negative, and V. So this is an ideal concept. Next, we have the practical concept, that is a practical voltage source. It is another term, practical voltage source. Practical voltage source. Practical voltage source is completely different from that of a constant voltage source. It is a practical concept, or it is in practical voltage source, the voltage across the terminals, voltage across the source terminals decreases as more current is drawn from it. That is the difference between constant voltage source and constant practical voltage source. In a practical voltage source, the voltage decreases gradually as more current is drawn from the source. And as such, a practical voltage source is considered to have very finite and low internal resistance. It is a practical concept. Practically, the voltage across the source will decreases as the current drawn from it increases. These are the two representations for voltage source, that is constant voltage source and practical voltage source. In constant voltage source, the terminal voltage is independent of the current drawn from it, whereas in practical voltage source, terminal voltage depends on the current drawn from it, or terminal voltage will decrease with the current drawn from it. A practical voltage source can be represented by connecting a small internal resistance R in series with the voltage source. Let's go through the characteristics, that is a voltage current VI characteristics of the constant voltage source and practical source. Constant voltage source, we know that the current is independent, the voltage is independent of the current drawn from it. So I put terminal voltage V on Y axis, current on X axis, then the voltage will remain constant no matter how much current is drawn from it. Therefore, the VI characteristics can be represented by a straight line. Whereas in case of a practical voltage source, this is a VI characteristics. We know that it has a small finite internal resistance R, therefore the VI characteristics, the voltage will decrease as a current drawn from it increases. V is a terminal voltage across source and I is the current drawn by the load, then the voltage across the source will decrease as the current drawn from it increases. This is a two representation for voltage source, that is a constant voltage source and practical voltage source. Thank you.